The Mars mission seems to be on everyone's mind. Billionaires are building rockets.
I think we could probably send the first person in about 12 years.
Hollywood is making blockbusters.
I'm alive. Surprise.
And citizens of Earth are signing up to leave their lives behind to colonize the red planet.
With my wife, it's a lot more tense.
But none of that will matter without one key element, food. NASA estimates that a round trip to Mars will take almost 5 years, and creating a food system that can sustain that trip is an unprecedented challenge.
The food system we have now has about a 1.5 to 3 year shelf life, and we need a 5 year shelf life for an exploration mission.
We went to the NASA Johnson Space Center to meet the people who are fueling human space exploration and tackling this unique challenge head on.
Rockets take rocket fuel, humans take human fuel, and human fuel is food.
This is What It Takes, looking at weird jobs that have an impact and the curiously inclined people who do them. Ryan Dowdy is a serious food nerd.
Hi, Michelle. How are you today? Good. Hi, Kelly. How are you today? Hi, Donna. Hi. Happy Tuesday.
He manages the food systems team at NASA, planning meals for astronauts.
In many ways, I'm like the manager of a restaurant who goes around to everyone's table and says, "Are you okay? Are you doing okay?" Except that it's astronauts.
In early space missions, astronauts didn't really get real food.
At the time, food was supplied in essentially toothpaste tubes and gelatinized cubes.
But astronauts were not really into it. So the food lab has been working to improve the eating experience by making real food that reminds them of home. But what makes food in space different than food on Earth?
Often, chefs will work to create a meal that's served immediately. Here in the food lab, food scientists are working to prepare and stabilize food that will be eaten in years.
Just getting to Mars and back would take 3 years. But once they land, astronauts will stay to grow crops for themselves and future explorers. That's why NASA wants to develop food that can last for 5 years, which is 2 years longer than what they can currently. With nowhere to stop for more food or water, everything that the crew will eat in transit has to be on board the shuttle to Mars. And there's just not a precedent for this kind of situation.
If you look at Arctic exploration, some of those missions were several years long like ours, but they had cold storage and they were able to hunt. And we don't have either of those capabilities when we go to Mars.
A journey like this introduces new challenges and old ones. Because vitamins break down over time, one of NASA's chief concerns is vitamin C deficiency, which causes scurvy. Growing crops on Mars will help, but counting on them as the only source of food is risky.
It takes a lot of time to do the research and build up that system so that you have confidence in that system, that you have it validated, that you know those crops are going to grow.
If for some reason they have trouble growing food on their own, it's important that astronauts have extra food to sustain them as they troubleshoot.
We're going to be on the Mars surface in the 2030s, so we're trying to get that 5 year shelf life figured out within the next 5 to 10 years.
So what does it take to make food that lasts a really long time? Precision.
When you think of a recipe at home, you're like, set the oven to this, and it's pretty quick, but here is a method to it.
First, the lab itself must be perfectly clean. Using mostly off-the-shelf ingredients that pass NASA's strict standards, they make huge servings of all their meals, like this quiche. Then, depending on the food, they either freeze-dry the food repeatedly or thermostabilize it to reduce the threat of bacteria. After that, it's vacuum-sealed to pull out oxygen and reduce its volume for travel. But before it can be signed off for delivery, everything is tested for quality and consistency.
The food industry uses a 1-9 scale, it's called the hedonic scale, to score foods. And all the foods have to get a 6 or higher in order to fly. This is our braised red cabbage, butternut squash, roasted Brussels sprouts, the sweet and savory kale.
All of this food is great for the International Space Station, which is much closer to Earth than Mars, but NASA is still searching for that 5-year solution. No matter what techniques they come up with to preserve food for that time, one thing will be in mind: how to make space feel like home.
So if we think about the way that we look at food here on Earth, we have holiday celebrations that are around food. We have family celebrations that are around food. And so we want our crew to have that same experience because that's important for them to be a cohesive team, and it's important for them to be able to bond over those food experiences.
With the Mars mission looming, Ryan, Race, Lynette, and the rest of the NASA Food Lab team are working to develop systems that are helping humans push the limits of space exploration, for now and for the future.
Space is extremely dangerous, and humans are incredibly fragile biological beings. In order for humans to survive, we've got to provide food that reminds them of good things. And that's what we work to do in the food lab.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked this video, you might like some of our other videos on the Freethink channel, so subscribe now and you'll get all of our latest releases.